Send your robot check-in, please. Please sit down. You're Jerry Bocek. I'm Dr. Cedric Elton, a psychiatrist. Do you have any idea at all why you've been brought to me?
Brought to you? Don't kid me, you're my old pal Gar Castle. Brought to you? How could I get away from you on this stinking tub?
Stinking tub?
Spaceship. Look, Gar, untie me, will you? This nonsense has gone far enough.
My name is Dr. Cedric Elton. You are not on a spaceship. You were brought to my office by the two police officers standing behind you.
What policemen? These two gear lockers.
You'd better get a hold of yourself, Gar. You're imagining things.
My name is Dr. Cedric Elton.
Your name is Gar Castle, and I refuse to call you Dr. Cedric Elton, because your name is Gar Castle. And I'm going to keep on calling you Gar Castle, because we have to have at least one peg of rationality in all this madness, or you will be cut completely adrift in this dream world you've cooked up.
Now that's funny. That's exactly what I was just going to say to you. Well, I guess that puts us on an even footing. You're nuts to me, and I'm nuts to you.
An equal footing is right. Except I'm tied up.
In a straight jacket.
Ropes.
You're dangerous. You killed 6 people. One of them a police officer, and wounded 2 others.
I blasted 5 Venusian lizard pirates who boarded our ship, and melted the door of 1 food locker, and seared the paint in 2 others. You know as well as I do, Gar, how space madness causes you to personify everything. That's why they drill into you, that as soon as you imagine there are more people aboard the ship than at the beginning of the trip, that you'd better go to the medicine locker and take a yellow pill. They can't hurt anything but a delusion.
If that is so, why are you in a straitjacket?
I'm tied up with ropes. You tied me up, remember?
And those 2 police officers behind your gear lockers? Okay. If one of those gear lockers comes around in front of you and taps you on the jaw with his fist, would you still believe that it's gear locker? Did you feel that?
Feel what? You imagine that one of the gear lockers, a police officer in your dream world, came around in front of me and hit me.
Don't you understand, Gar, that it didn't really happen? Untie me and I'll prove it. Before your very eyes, I'll open the door on your police officer and take out the pressure suit or magnetic grapple or whatever's in it. Who are you afraid to? You've surrounded yourself with all sorts of protective delusions. I'm tied with ropes, but you imagine it to be a straitjacket. You imagine yourself to be a psychiatrist named Dr. Cedric Elton so that you can convince yourself that you're sane and I'm crazy. Probably you imagine yourself a very famous psychiatrist that everyone would like to come to for treatment. World famous, no doubt. Probably you even think you have a beautiful receptionist. What is her name?
Helena Fitzroy.
It figures. Helena Fitzroy is the expeditor at Marsport. You try to date her every time we land there, but she won't date you.
Eat him again. Now, is it my imagination? Or is your head still rocking from the blow?
What blow? I felt no blow.
You mean to say that there is no corner of your mind, no slight residue of rationality that tries to tell you that your rationalizations aren't reality?
I have to admit, when you seem so absolutely certain that you're right and I'm nuts, it almost makes me doubt. Untie me, Gar, and let's try to work things out sensibly. You know, Gar, one of us has to be nuttier than a fruitcake.
If I had the officers take off your straitjacket, what would you do? Try to double gun and kill some more people.
That's one of the things I'm worried about. If those pirates came back with me tied up, you're just space crazy enough to welcome them aboard. That's why you mustn't tie me. Our lives depend on it, Gar.
Where would you get the gun?
Where they're always kept, in the gear lockers.
I'm afraid we can't take your straitjacket off just yet. I'm going to have the officers take you back now. I'll talk with you again tomorrow. Meanwhile, I want you to think seriously about things. Try to get below this level of rationalization that rules you from reality. Once you make it into it, the whole delusion will vanish. All right, take him away. Bring him back tomorrow at the same time.
I'll try to do that, Gar. And I hope you do the same thing. I'm much encouraged. Several times I detected genuine doubt in your eyes. Oh, yes. And take one of those yellow pills in the medicine cabinet. It's quite hurt you.
Today was rough.
I only have a little more of this last transcript. I'll sort them out in the morning. It was rough, wasn't it, Doctor? That dual Perchik is the most unusual patient you've had since I've worked for you. And poor Mr. Potts, a brilliant executive, making $500,000 a year. And he has to give it up. He seems so normal.
He is normal. People with above normal blood pressure often have very minor cerebral hemorrhages, so small that the effect there is no larger than the head of a pin. All that happens is that they completely forget things that they knew. They can relearn them, but a man whose judgment must always be perfect can't afford to take a chance. He's already made one error in judgment that cost his company $1.5 million. That's why I consented to take him on as a... General Bocek really upset me, Helena. I consent to take a $500,000 a year executive as a patient.
He was frightening, wasn't he? I don't mean so much because he's a mass murderer as...
I know. Let's prove him wrong. Have dinner with me.
We agree that...
Let's break the agreement this once.
Especially not now. Besides, it wouldn't prove anything. He's got you boxed in on that point. It would only show that a wish fulfillment entered your dream.
Ouch! That's a dirty word. I wonder how he knew about the yellow pills. I can't get it out of my mind, the fact that if we had spaceships, and if there was a type of space madness in which we began to personify objects, a yellow pill would be the right thing to stop that.
How?
They almost triple the strength of nerve currents from end organs. What results is that reality practically shuts down any fantasy insertions. It's quite startling. I took one 3 years ago when they first became available. You'd be surprised at how little you actually see of what you look at, especially of people. You look at symbol inserts instead. I had to cancel my appointments for a week. I found that I couldn't do my work without my professionally built-in symbol inserts of people that enable me to see them not as they really are, but as a complex of normal and abnormal symptoms.
I'd like to take one sometime.
That's a twist. One of the characters in the dream world takes a yellow pill and discovers that it doesn't exist at all except as a fantasy.
Why don't you both take one?
I couldn't do my work.
You're afraid you might wake up on a spaceship?
Maybe I am. Crazy, isn't it? But there's one thing that stands out today as a serious flaw in my reality. It's so glaring that I'm actually afraid to ask you about it.
Are you serious?
I am. How does it happen that the police brought General Bocek here to my office? Instead of holding him in the psychiatric ward at City Hospital and having me go there to see him, how does it happen that the DA didn't get in touch with me beforehand and discuss the case?
I don't know. I received no call. They just showed up, and I assumed that they wouldn't have without you knowing about it. Mrs. Fortescue was your first patient, and I called her up just as she was leaving the house. And I told an emergency case had come up.
Now we know how the patient must feel. Terrifying, isn't it, to think that if I took a yellow pill, all this might vanish. My years of college, my internship, my fame as the world's best known psychiatrist, and you. Tell me, Helena, are you sure you want an expeditor at Marsport?
Elena, before you send in General Bocek, get me the DA on the phone.
Hello, Dave? About this patient, General Bocek.
I was going to call you today. I called you yesterday morning at 10, but no one answered, and I haven't had time since. Our police psychiatrist, Walters, says you might be able to snap Bocek out of it in a couple of days. At least long enough so that we can get some sensible answers out of him. Down underneath his delusion of killing lizard pirates from Venus, there has to be some reason for that mass killing. And the press is after us on this.
But why bring him to my office? It's okay, of course, but that's... I didn't think you could take a patient out of the ward at City Hospital and transport him around town.
I thought that would be less of an imposition on you. I'm in a hurry on it.
Oh, well, okay, Dave. He's out in the waiting room. I'll do my best to snap him back to reality for you. Less of an imposition. Send General Bocek in, please.
Good morning, Gar. Did you sleep well last night? I heard you mumbling to yourself most of the evening.
I am going to send you in, Carlton.
And this is your office.
And this is your office.
And this is your office, Dr. Arthur. A very impressive office. That thing you're sitting behind is not the chart table, but your desk, I gather. All metal, with a great finish, isn't it?
Now you begin to understand. All right. Over here to my left is an intercom made of grey plastic, and directly in front of me is a telephone.
Let me see if I can tell you your telephone number. Is it Mulberry 59011?
Hello, it's Cedar.
So, you said it's Cedar 74309, isn't it?
So you did read it, you were just having a fun.
If you say so.
What other explanation can you have for the fact that it is my number, if you are unable to actually see reality? Once you realize that your mind has walled off your consciousness from reality, and is substituting a rationalized type of symbology in its place. It shouldn't be long until you begin to break through. Once you begin to see one thing as it really is, the rest of the delusion will disappear.
Level, I have the idea, a rationalization of course, that I'm beginning to catch on to the pattern of your imagination, so that when you give me one or two key elements, I can fill in the rest. But I'm going to try, really try, Dr. Alton.
I'll see you tomorrow, same time. We should make the breakthrough then. The rest of my appointments.
But why?
Because I'm upset. How did a madman whom I never knew till yesterday know your phone number?
He could have looked it up in a phone book.
Locked in a room in the psychiatric ward at City Hospital? How did he know your name yesterday?
Why, he could have looked at my nameplate.
Yes, of course. I'd forgotten about that. I'm so accustomed to it being there that I never really see it. Thank you.
cancelled all our appointments for today. Why don't you go out on the golf course? A change will do you.
You look so frightened. Is it because if I take this yellow pill, you'll cease to exist?
Don't joke.
I'm not joking. Out there, when you mentioned about your brass nameplate and your desk, when I looked down, it was blurred for just a second, and then became sharply distinct and solid. And into my head popped the memory that the first thing I do when I have to get a new receptionist is get a brass nameplate for a desk. And when she quits, I make her a present of it.
All about it when I started working for you. But that's the truth. You told me all about it when I started working for you. You also told me...
Remember, a nice pat rationalization in any man's reality to make the rejection be my own before you could have time to reject me yourself. Preserving the ego is one of the first principles of manhood.
But it isn't. Oh, darling, I'm here. This is real. I don't care whether you fire me or not. I've loved you forever. And you mustn't let this mess mood get you down. I actually think he isn't insane at all, but has just figured out a way to seem insane, so he won't have to pay for his crime.
You think so? It's a possibility. But you'd have to be good a psychiatrist as I am. You see, delusions of grandeur.
Sure. Napoleon was obviously insane because he thought he was Napoleon.
Perhaps. But if all this is real, my taking this yellow pill will not change that, but only confirm the fact.
And make it impossible for you to do your work for a week?
A small price to pay for sanity. No, I'm going to take it.
No! Cat.
Hey, Helena. Did you know that all this time you were only a creature of my imagination? The reason I wanted to know is... Oh, I feel like I'm dying. I didn't feel like this the first time I took one.
Can you stand up?